Dashboard in a Day 2023 continues, and this time we're going to take a look at lab number 3. We actually get into the data visualizations. We're going to build out the first complete dashboard of this course. And remember, you can follow along by going to Dashboard in a Day. Search for that in your search engine. We also have it in a link below in the description. In parts 1 and 2, we loaded the data. We did some beginning data exploration. We added some slicers. We also did some connected to a couple of sources of data, CSV and an Excel file. This is lab 3, and we continue along. Make sure to follow along. Labs 1 and 2, we did a video combined, and then there's a series of 6 videos to get you all the way up to this point. So make sure to watch those videos as we continue along. Download the resources and we continue along in Power BI. Back in Power BI, lab number 3, what we have done now is went through the first 2 stages of the data preparation. We loaded the data, we made some transformations in Power Query. We started to do some of the data exploration, and from the digital dashboard in a day, we have downloaded the completed lab 2 so that we are all on the same data set. We refresh the data and we're all set to go. Remember, we have our sum of revenue by country chart. We have our sum of revenue by year. First thing we're going to start off with is in the matrix chart. We are going to select that chart and we are going to add conditional formatting. Now, when you select the conditional formatting button, there's 2 options. You've got the data button and then you have the add or removing visual elements. And that is what we are going to select in the matrix chart. With that, we are going to go to the cell elements. And the cell elements allows you to add either conditional formatting, background colors, icons. And the first thing we are going to do is you can choose from the matrix which of the columns you want to add the conditional formatting to. So you have sum of revenue. You have percentage revenue growth, percentage of grand total revenue, and the prior year sales in this matrix. We are going to choose the percentage growth. Then your options in the cell elements include the background color, the font color, data bars, icons, and a web URL. We are going to select turn on the background color. So that brings in the background color for percentage growth. Now we want to change that and add a middle color. This will add that third color to make it more of a high to low type gradient. So by adding that and then selecting OK, we now add that into the visual element. So we now have that inside the middle color. So that is the percentage of conditional formatting. And we have added that for Van. And currently, remember, this is selected on Van Arsdale. So if we go to, we're currently filtered to the USA, and we can unfilter that. And you start to see some of those gradients when you select either the year or the other manufacturers. So you can see that conditional formatting in action. Let's continue to focus in on the drill down feature in Power BI. Let's select the sum of revenue by country and we're going to hit the drill down button. That will turn on the drill down and we are going to select Australia. And when you select Australia, we then drill down to the states. And we will disable the drill down mode, revenue by country and state visual. So that turns it off. Now, when we take a look at the percentage of growth for 2021, we see the percentage of growth having that conditional formatting we just set in there. At this point, we're ready to move on to the next part of the data visualizations. Again, reminder, the dashboard in a day course is really just to show you all of the options. The best way to do this course is to, as you're doing some of the visualizations, as you're working through the dashboard in a day, think about how you can apply this to your business, your data, and how you want to set up some of your different visualizations in your Power BI. So we're going to work now on the manufacturing slicer and do the next visualization. Next, we are going to select the manufacturer visual, and we are now going to add or remove visual options. And for the slicer settings, we are going to make this a tile. And that shows us some of the different options for the tile. Let's make some room for this tile. Let's move this visual over and we'll bring our tile visual down and we'll make it a little bit bigger. And now we will select Van Arsdale and see the different filters. Now we are going to add the image URLs for the manufacturing logos. So if you select on the logo in the manufacturing and then for the data category, we are going to select image URL. That will make the logo a image URL. Then we select on the manufacturing and on the data tab, we're going to delete the manufacturer and we are now going to add the logo and that will bring up our logos for the different companies. So we're going to position this at the top of our dashboard. We'll move this down, we'll move this over, and now we have our logos for each of the different manufacturers. Next, we are going to select the revenue by year, and we're going to make this from currently, it is a clustered column, and we are now going to switch this to a line and clustered column chart. So when we add that, and then for the data, on the y-axis, we are going to add the percentage growth from the measure we created. And now we add the line axis. The next step is to turn the current card visual. This is a card visual that we created in lab number 2. And now we are going to make this into a gauge. It's this little gauge symbol in the data visualization category, and the only difference we're going to change to this is the target value is going to be the prior year sales, which is the measure we created in lab number 2. So now we've set up the gauge. Now that we've created the gauge visual and added in the logos, let's start to resize and configure this into the final dashboard we are going to end up with. So we are going to move a few things around and remember chart visualization and building a dashboard is kind of an art and a science. There's no particular size that it needs to be and you can also move some things around. So the first thing we're going to do is move the gauge over here. We're going to make this a little bit smaller for now. And we're going to move the matrix to the right. The sum of revenue chart is going to get moved to the right. And we got to fit all of this in. We are going to bring over the logos and the revenue by country chart. We're going to make smaller. And we're going to move that over here. So we're starting to build out this dashboard. We still have quite a bit of work to do, but at least this way we kind of start to move some of the elements into the right spots as we continue to build out the dashboard. Next step is start to show you some of the different themes that are available in Power BI. We're going to check on the gauge metric and we're going to start to work on some of the themes. If you go to view, these are built-in themes, and the different themes have names for them. This is Bloom. This is City Park. This is Classic. The one we are going to choose is the temperature theme. And that switches the entire theme on the report. So that is how you change the theme for the entire report. Now, you can also, besides the built-in themes, you can create themes and manage your theme. So in the dashboard in a day materials, you can select a theme that the marketing department uses for all of its themes. So if you go browse for themes and you go into the materials, there is a theme and we're going to use that, and that will then import into the gallery. And now when you choose, it successfully imported that theme, and now that one is actually able to be used. And that is where we can now change the theme on the different reports. So that theme is being used and we'll continue on. We're going to use digital in a dashboard theme number 2. And that is the theme that is going to be used. And now we're starting to build out that dashboard slowly and starting to see some of the different features. So the next thing we're going to do is format the gauge icon. So we're going to select the gauge icon. Next, we are going to change the target label on the gauge. When you click on that visual and you click on the more options under the gauge axis, we're going to change the color, and the target color is currently that light blue. We are now going to change that to black in the gauge. We're going to make 2 more changes to the gauge visual. We are going to check the data labels and make that 10 point. You'll notice the size changed a little bit smaller, and then the target label is currently 12 point. We are going to make that 10 point as well. Those are some of the options from the formatting options for the gauge visual. And all of the different visuals have options that allow you to make the visual easier to understand, easier to read, change the size bigger or smaller. You can change the font. Next, we're going to start working on the matrix visual. We're in lab 3 of Dashboard in a Day. Make sure to look for the link to the Dashboard in a Day materials in the description below. And check out the previous videos, parts 1 through 6, or we combine them all into one file. So you can do labs 1 and 2 in Dashboard in a Day. It's Dashboard in a Day 2023 and lab 3. This is part 1. We're going to come back in part 2 of lab 3.